Hey subbies, it's your girl Sophia. I'm just checking in to see how much my hair has grown. Been a while. And I'm about to wash my hair. So you could see the problem areas haven't fully grown in completely, like right here. This is the biggest, you know, the worst area of my hair. Yeah, so it's got a way to go, but you could tell that it's come a very, very long way, right? And the other side was right here. This was my other temple. So the two temples, you could tell, like this one is still pretty bad, but as I say, growing. And then this one is not as bad, but you could tell like it's still a little thin. And then my crown, does my crown look like now? So hopefully you could see, that's what my crown looks like now. So still a little ways to go, but really overall, I have to say that I'm pleased with my progress. And part of the reason I'm so pleased is because, especially in the last month, I've been going through a lot of things and I just haven't had the opportunity to really take care of myself the way that I want to. My hair has taken like the backseat. So I haven't, like I said, done much to it. It hasn't been getting much moisturizing. The only thing I do every day is I have a little bottle and I put, aloe vera gel in it. And so I fill it up with aloe vera gel and I opened a moringa capsule. And then what I actually do with it is I mix it, like, you know, just shake up the bottle. It's a little bottle like this. Just fill it up with the aloe vera juice, a gel actually, but I guess you could use a juice. I have gel, I don't have any juice. And then I just put in the open a moringa capsule, throw in it, and then I use like some tea tree oil or like the peppermint oil. Those are the essential oils, and I just put like, you know, one or two drops of each in it, and then I just basically shake it up, and then it's got this little thing here. So then I just fill it up every morning and I put it on these affected areas, like right here and, you know, wherever, and then I just kind of rub it in, massage it in, and then I put my scarf thing on and then put my wig on, because usually my hair is cornrowed all the time. I just cornrowed back so I can get my wig on very easily. So that's what I've been doing. Like I said, I haven't been keeping up with my regular stuff. So haven't been having my smoothies, haven't been taking a lot of greens, haven't been eating lots of salads, none of that. Like, I've been really bad, y'all, in the past maybe month and a half, even maybe even longer. I haven't been taking my vitamins, so I'm like tired as hell. Today was a rough day. I slept for most of the day, so I know that I really gotta get it together. So starting tonight, after I have my dinner, I'm gonna take my vitamins, you know, and then I'm gonna start keeping up with my stuff, because I've noticed a change throughout my whole body and my mood and everything. Like, I'm just not in alignment with myself. But anyways, enough of that. Just wanted you to see what's up with my hair. I'm gonna try to put a picture up, maybe at the intro is where, or just on the photo, whatever. I'll just put a photo at the front so you could kind of get an idea to see what my hair, where my hair is coming from, if you haven't been watching for a while. If you have been watching, I really appreciate you. You guys, you know, especially you guys that sub and comment, you know, and send me messages to keep me motivated, because I kind of think in the back of my head, at some point I gotta go online and, you know, let everybody know, you know, what I've been up to and how my hair is doing. So, you know, at least I do something instead of doing nothing, because I know a lot of people are like even checking in on my progress to kind of help them stay motivated as well. So I feel a little responsible, which is kind of cool, because it's helping me also to just keep up and have a flow going and make sure that I keep my hair I keep working at getting my my bald spots filled in, because I know it's so important to us as women. Alopecia is such a devastating matter that we unfortunately don't talk about enough, and I really want to even start working on the awareness of it in my community in Toronto, because I've noticed a lot of people are really hush about it, and they're really being torn. Like, people are, you know, it's a serious matter. Like, people are literally committing suicide for, you know, the effects of alopecia. It's so devastating for some women, most women, and it was for myself. Even though I was coming on here and I was talking, and I wasn't really talking about the deep effects of what I was really going through, but it really did attack my self-esteem. It attacked my whole belief of how I saw myself, and questioned my beauty and a bunch of stuff. And, you know, it affected my thought of what I thought my value was. So I really want to keep at it, you know, for the sake of especially the younger girls that have been sending me messages, you know, keep on it, you know. Your hair doesn't make you, you know, or hair is just a small part, like a very, very small percentage of who we are, but it does matter, you know. And if you can do something about it, and if you can at least try, then, you know, in the long run, it won't hurt to try. Like, you know, it's not very expensive to do stuff, you know, in terms of the remedies and stuff. They're in your kitchen, most of them, onions. You know, if you have no money to go out and buy all the oils and so forth, you know, do an onion mask every now and again, you know. And I have a tutorial in onion mask, and you don't have to use all the ingredients. If you want, you could just use onion and water if that's all you have, you know. Or if you have anything else, you can kind of put other stuff in it. But I did an onion mask tutorial on my other channel, which is Fire Natural, which is the one that I'm supposed to be doing tutorials on. But like I said, I've been very off balance. So I really want to get back into that. But if you want to check out, you know, you could even just Google it. There are other people doing the onion mask tutorials. There's a Fire Natural YouTube website that I did a tutorial on, and you can always check my blog, firenaturals.com, and you can see a bunch of different remedies that I use myself in my hair, and that's been helping me along the way, like the kind of stuff that I've been eating and, you know, using in my smoothies, or stuff that I've been using topically on my scalp to kind of help me through the journey. So, you know, be sure the information is there. It's free for everyone. It's just to share what I've been using and what's been working for me. I'm pretty sure that if I was more consistent, my results would be, you know, much faster. But again, like, my priorities have been all over the place recently, so I haven't put a lot of focus on my hair, although I haven't completely deserted it. But yeah, I want you guys to keep in touch, you know. If you like the video, don't forget, press that like button, like it, comment, you know. If you're shy, or, you know, you want to keep your hair issues private, you know, some people do it privately, send me messages, or go to my Facebook page, facebook.com/firenaturals, and you can leave me a message there as well, or you can leave me a message here, whatever. Like, I do get back to everyone, you know. I do always promise to, and I make it a point to make sure that I reach out to you. So if you're feeling like you're alone, you're not alone. Like, at least 1 in 3 people lose their hair at some point in their life. Some cases, of course, are more severe than others, but I don't know, I'm just a strong believer that the body has the capacity to heal itself if given the time, and if you put the effort into it, and you use the right things that the body really is lacking. So because I believe that, I know my hair could grow back. Like, I didn't care what anybody else told me, like, oh, you know, if it's scarring alopecia in those areas or whatever, it's traction and it's going to take you like many, many years to grow back, or it may never grow back, you like, whatever. Like, these areas that it hasn't fully grown back, like, it's come a long way, and I'm believing that, I believe and I trust it's going to come back, you know. And I'm not going to hold my breath and stop my life and say, you know, I'm no good and I'm worthless if my hair doesn't grow back. But I'm going to do something about it to try to, you know, help it to grow back. So I think I've been yanting a little bit too much, thinking, chatting, talking, yapping. That's it. yapping a little bit too much. So I'm gonna go now because I got two little girls that I need to get to go take a shower so that we can head out on the road. So keep in touch. Don't forget, you know, like, subscribe, comment, message me. Check out my blog, financials.com, and, you know, just stay connected, all right? And if you're in the Toronto area and you're interested in helping me to put together a support group, reach out, okay? I'm here. I'm ready. All right. Peace. Love.